much, Sherry Enchantress. I'm here with a book series, the books that changed my life, and the next up is The Secret. Before I talk about The Secret, though, I did a reading, and this card came up again, Deception card, and before I talk about that, I wanted to show you, you know, how many of these cards have this gilded edging. And you can do this yourself if you want to on cards, on your oracle cards, if you, on any of them that don't have that. I think it's really pretty. And then that brings me to the subject that, well, before I was a grade school kid reading Beverly Cleary and Judy Blume, I used to like sit down next to the World Book Encyclopedia and look things up as a little kid. And the World Book Encyclopedia had that neat gold edging on it, and it was a little bit powdery, so it would leave like sparkles. So yeah, I had fairy dust back then, and I had knowledge to go with it. And that's probably one of my favorite subjects to look up in the World Book Encyclopedia. Were animals, dogs and cats, and astronomy. So I like to look at the planets and things having to do with the planets. I think I probably did look up astrology, but I guess I probably didn't know what it was back then. But I remember being fascinated by constellations and stars and stuff like that. So anyway, that did have an effect on me as a really young child. So now to this card. So usually when deception comes up, it says someone is wearing a false mask, self-mask in this relationship. Somebody's hiding something. They could be cheating, something like that. And when it came up, this last reading that I had, I try to give it a positive spin because, you know, it doesn't always have to be something negative. So in my reading, I said that that you are good at keeping somebody's secrets, which that's another option. And then I realized, you know what else it could be? Because, alright, so let me try to sort my brain, because so much flooded in my brain at the moment. So I was thinking how when we're trying to manifest something in our lives, and yes, we decide what we want, we have a want, then we do, you know, picture it and to try to attract it and do all that comes with that. And then you have to let it go, because when it comes to you, it's going to be like a surprise. So that made me think, oh, it's kind of like planning a surprise party or something. It's or when, you know, somebody that loves you wants to surprise you in a good way, you know. Or like when somebody wants to propose to you, they might be very deceptive, you know, but you might wonder, what's going on? Why are they acting so strange? Why are they avoiding me? Why are not, you know, they might be acting a little bit different because they're trying to plan something without you knowing what they're planning. So then I was thinking, that's another thing that the deception card could be about, you know, somebody might be planning something in the works behind the scenes and hiding it from you because it's a surprise. So, on to the secret. Alright, so I don't know if you know. If you know what the secret is, then yay, you're ahead of the game. If you don't, I'm a little bit reluctant to tell you because I want you to discover it on your own like a surprise. You know, it's exciting, it's a surprise, it's a secret that's going to be revealed. But I will tell you this, it changed my life. It's talks about the law of attraction, similar to the creative visualization. Creative visualization is kind of like a book of exercises, things to do. It's kind of like explains how to envision things, right? How to get a picture, whatever, explains how. The secret's neat because it tells you where all of this concepts came from, and it encompasses every belief system, every religion. Even if you're an atheist and only believe in your own power, it covers everything. So the secret is great. And there's a lot of philosophers cited in here. Also, if you are not really great at reading, you don't like to read, you don't like books necessarily, but you're really curious about the secret, it does come in DVD. So that's a great. The movie is great too. It's very inspirational. It really is moving. It doesn't have all the same detail as the book does, but I think it's equally helpful and moving, and will really put you in the right frame of mind to make some changes in your life. So everybody now, you know somewhat what the secret is about. Anybody who does not want me to reveal what the secret is should probably stop watching right now, because I think I might reveal the secret. So I kind of already revealed it, but anyway, what is the secret? You've probably been sitting there wondering, what is the secret? Alright, so this is how the author has come to understand it. We all work with one infinite power. We all guide ourselves by exactly the same laws. The natural laws of the universe are so precise that we don't even have any difficulty building spaceships. We can send people to the moon, and we can time the landing with the precision of a fraction of a second. Wherever you are, India, Australia, New Zealand, Stockholm, London, Toronto, Montreal, or New York, we're all working with one power, one law. It's attraction. Ta-da! Which is, and it can, it also is called the law of love, which is really cool. Like later on in the book, she refers to it as the law of love as well. The secret is the law of attraction. Everything that is coming into your life, you are attracting into your life. It is, and it's attracted to you by virtue of the images you're holding in your mind. It's what you're thinking. Whatever is going on in your mind, you are attracting to you. A friend of mine had a saying that was, what you think about, you bring about. That's a great saying. You know, you remind yourself of that saying. What you think about, you bring about. This is really, really important. So, when you focus your thoughts on something you want, and you hold that focus, you are at the moment summoning what you want with the mightiest power in the universe. The law of attraction doesn't compute don't, or not, or no, or any other words of negation. As you speak words of a negation, this is what the law of attraction is receiving. So if you say, I don't want to spill something on this outfit, you're telling the universe, I want to spill something on this outfit, and I want to spill more things. When you say, I don't want a bad haircut, you're saying, I want bad haircuts. Many of them. I don't want to be delayed. I want delays. I don't want that person to be rude to me. I want that person and more people to be rude to me. I don't want the restaurant to give away our table. I want restaurants to give away our tables. I don't want these shoes to hurt. I want shoes to hurt. Any kind of shoe. I need it to hurt me. I can't handle all this work. I want more work than I can handle. I don't want to catch the flu. I want the flu, and I want to catch more things. I don't want to argue. I want more arguing. Don't speak to me like that. I want you to speak to me like that, and I want other people to speak to me like that. You see what's happening here? This was like, oh, when I first read that, I was like, oh, okay. The law of attraction is giving you what you're thinking about. So you might have all the best intentions when you're thinking what you don't want in your life, but that's not going to do you any good with the universe. The universe only wants to hear what you do want, okay? So this is going to take a little work, but you have to find the right adjectives and form your sentences and phrases in a positive form. You guys, when you're asking yes or no questions to the tarot, you gotta do it the same way. Think of the positive way to say that, because the universe and the angels and fairies, they get a little confused with all this don't and no stuff. You know, they need to hear the positive version of this question so they can answer yes or no correctly. So that's another thing that you have to do. The law of attraction is the law of creation. Quantum physics tell us that the entire universe emerged from thought. You create your life through your thoughts and the law of attraction, and every single person does the same. It doesn't just work if you know about it. It has always been working in your life and every other person's life throughout history. When you become aware of this great law, then you become aware of how incredibly powerful you are to be able to think your life into existence. So, what's interesting about that is even the every law, like everything that I've been reading to you, everything about astrology and all of that doesn't even matter. It's only what you think, you know? Really, it is only what you think. So you can believe in that stuff if it makes you feel good, and it makes me feel good. I like it. So it's good to think of things that give you good vibes. That is good, and there's nothing wrong with it, you know? But if you're thinking of things that give you bad vibes, you might be attracting that stuff to you. So that's up to you. If you don't want to attract the negative, don't think the negative. If you like astrology and like, you know, if you like to see things as some things are positive and some things are negative, that's fine. If you like to see balance, that's fine. If you like to see yourself as a more of a positive person, then that's good, you know, because then you'll attract positive. It gets kind of tricky, and you have to, you know, kind of stop yourself sometimes because your thoughts might run away with you. And, you know, it's not your fault. Like, we've been programmed a lot with negativity. A lot of us have grown up with that, you know. I was very, very blessed to have a mother that was extremely optimistic and full of faith. If I didn't have her, it would have been really hard because my dad was the opposite. He was negative, negative, negative. I mean, he even put a sign on the wall saying negativity. I don't know, like pessimism was, you know, the ruler, whatever. He had Murphy's Law posted on the wall. Anything negative, he felt it was some kind of protection to be negative. And that it's being realistic, but that's not realistic. Reality is what you make of it, and that's what the secret is saying. Reality is not something that's just thrust upon you, and here it is, this is reality. You make your reality, you create your world. Now, everybody is doing their own thing. That's where you have to kind of maneuver through other people's realities, and they may be negative, and they may be saying things, and it might affect you. Their thoughts, spoken out loud, can plant a seed that can make you think similar thoughts, and therefore you attract the things that they're attracting, those negative things that you don't want to attract. So you have to be conscious, like be aware of these things daily. Be aware of how people say things, and you might have to just remind yourself sometimes, hey, don't say that, don't repeat that to yourself, or turn it around in your head, send out a positive note to the universe. Anyway, that's the beginning of the secret. There's, what's interesting about the secret, there's like steps you can do. So, I'm trying to remember the steps, or let me look them up. I'll just remember them. Well, first of all, you have to give thanks for what you have right now. Love the place and the moment and the people and the the surroundings that you're in at this moment and give thanks for it. Give thanks for everything, especially when you do want something, you wish for it, and it comes into your life. Give thanks for it. I mean, the thankfulness sends a great, great vibe and message out into the universe. Then when you, so the process of getting what you want, that is what the secret will take you through. So first you think of a want, be real clear about what you want, then you focus on it, and you can say something out loud. I want a new car, let's say. Okay, let's use that as an example. I want a new car. Then what you do is you imagine all the details of the car. You imagine what color it is, you imagine the make and model, everything really, really detailed about the car. Then you sit there and imagine your hands wrapped around the steering wheel of this car. Visualize yourself driving the actual car that you actually want and smiling and feeling happy. All the feelings that you would feel if you had that car, it's like an acting scene, but you know, you have to believe it and get your mind in the position of really being there in that moment, because it's really, that moment is there. It's all about time, you know? Yesterday is today's tomorrow. Past, present, and future, they're all one. Our reality tells us we're feeling them at different times, that time is sort of one line or whatever. It's not one line, but that's the way we're able to cope with time, is by seeing it that way. A clock and a line and days and weeks and months and whatever. But it's not as simple as that. Time is not simple. It's very complex and dimensional and layered. And everything that our manifestations are there. They're just right there. You just have to visualize it, and then it'll be there. It'll be there, kind of like magic. So that's what you do. You put yourself in the car. You feel the cushion of the seat. You smell the leather, that new car smell. You feel it purring, the way it drives down the road. Just all these little details as you imagining. And then you say thank you, universe, and thank you for this car, and it's awesome, and I feel great, and I feel happy. You just associate all kinds of positive energy and words and thoughts towards this. The one thing that a lot of us mistake is we worry about how we're going to get the car. Of course, cars cost money. Sure, you can plan and stuff, but the universe can take care of that. That's what I mean by it's a little surprise that they're in the works, behind the scenes, they're working on it. You sent out the I want message, they computed, they're like, okay, yeah, we got this. Go ahead about your business. We take care of this. We take care of the rest. Then you go about your business, and then bam, you know, timing though, that's a different issue. It may take a long time or a short time or whatever, but you'll get your wish, and it might be what you wish for, something better, but it'll be right there the way you imagined it. And especially if you let it go, let it go after you wish for it or after you made your want, desire. You let it go, let the universe take care of it. The universe will say, here you go, and then you're like, whoa, that's a nice surprise, you know? That's kind of how it works. So it's like, whoa, that's a nice surprise. Like, they're like, shh, okay, we got this, we're doing something behind the scenes, you know? Of course, the universe is not deceptive, but the universe works in mysterious ways. Definitely that. Mysterious ways. Ways that you can't always compute or understand. But it will happen the way it's meant to happen, and that's intended. And you're living the life right now that you're meant to live and be, have joy in every moment, every touch of a friend's hand, smile from a lover, a mother. mother, child, whatever, you know, the beautiful sun, the cool rain, all of the things that make your surroundings and the people and the love and joy in your life, it's a wonderful world. And that's what you got to think of, and you bring more of that wonderful world into your life. So the secret book itself gets a little in depth, and it talks a little bit more, but in general it's a very simple book and very simple concept. It talks about ways you can envision things, manifest things into your life. I bought this book probably 10 times because I keep giving it away, because I'm like, yes, you need to read The Secret. You were meant to read The Secret. I have to do this in two parts, so this is part two. You can just stop watching now, or we can go through the different steps that you have to take. But before we do, I was just going to say a little bit of how I found The Secret. So one day, I'm a school bus driver, and I used to do field trips, which I really enjoyed that. And this field trip was awesome because I got to go to a water park and put on, bathing suit, a very modest bathing suit with shorts, and I knew I was going to be kind of lounging around. Like, I really wasn't going to get in the water. I was just going to kind of get some sun. And I'm thinking, I need a good book to read while I'm sitting out there lounging in the sun. So first I stopped at Target, and I looked around, and then I saw this. This was like, I mean, this is irresistible to a Scorpio. It's like, what? What is The Secret? I must find out. And so I bought the book. I didn't read it until I got out into the sun, and then laying there, my brain just went pew, pew, pew. I was like, what is this? Oh my God, this is amazing. Yes, I get it. This is like everything I was reading. It's like, yeah, my mom taught me that, and my mom taught me that, and my mom taught me. It was just kind of, you know, things you just learn throughout childhood, different religions, different philosophies, they were just all popping up, and I was like, this makes so much sense, you know. And then immediately, sort of, you know, after, I don't know how many pages I read, but after I got through it a little bit, I was trying to put it into practice right away. I was standing in the line for ice cream and trying to make the line go faster. Anyway, but it does work. So I'm going to show you the steps. Okay. Step one is ask. So, first step is to ask. Make a command to the universe. Let the universe know what you want. The universe responds to your thoughts. What do you really want? Sit down and write it out on a piece of paper. Write it in the present tense. You might begin by writing, I am so happy and grateful now that, blah, blah, blah. And then explain how you want your life to be in every area. So the positive creative visualization works really great with this. If the first part of ask, you can use creative visualization to help you with that. All those worksheets and tests and meditations and stuff, that's a great start. So you get to choose what you want, but you must get clear about what you want. This is your work. If you're not clear, then the law of attraction cannot bring you what you want. You will be sending out a mixed frequency, and you can only attract mixed results. For the first time in your life, perhaps, work out what it is you really want. Now that you know you can have or be or do anything, and there are no limits, what do you want? I think, you know, that was sort of the hardest part for me, because I'm such a pleaser. Like, I never really bothered anybody about what I want. Sometimes, though, I did. I had my desires, my wishes, my wants, and I often had trouble verbalizing them or expressing them, but now I'm getting much better at that. Okay, so asking is the first step in the creative process, so make it a habit to ask. If you have to make a choice and you don't know which way to go, ask. You should never be stumped on anything in your life. Just ask. This is really fun. It's like having the universe as your catalog. You flip through it and say, I'd like to have this experience, and I'd like to have that product, and I'd like to have a person like that. It is you placing your order with the universe. It's really that easy. You do not have to ask over and over again, just ask once. It is exactly like placing an order from a catalog. You only ever order something once. You don't place an order and then doubt the order has been received. So place the order again and then again and then again. You order once. It's the same with the creative process. Step one is simply your step to get clear about what you want. As you get clear in your mind, you have asked. Okay. Step two, believe. Step two is believe. Believe that it's already yours. Have what I love to call unwavering faith, believing in the unseen. You must believe that you have received. You must know that what you want is yours the moment you ask. You must have complete and utter faith. If you've placed an order from a catalog, you would relax, know you're going to receive what you ordered, and get on with your life. If it takes too long, then you might, you know, look up the tracking number, but whatever, you know. Or like in my case, I am waiting for some wings, okay? So I looked it up and it said, you will expect your wings on October 18th. And I'm like, okay. So you can look at it like that. You know, you made an order. You can expect this to arrive on a certain date. See the things that you want as already yours. Know that they will come to you at need. Then let them come. Don't fret and worry about them. Don't think about your lack of them. Think of them as yours, as belonging to you, as already in your possession. In the moment, you ask and believe and know. Knowing's even better than believing. As Linda Goodman would say, believe has the word lie in it, and so it's not 100% sure. But knowing, that's different. That's really being sure. So know you already have it in the unseen. The entire universe shifts to bring it into the seen. You must act, speak, and think as though you're receiving it now. Why? The universe is a mirror, and the law of attraction is mirroring back to you your dominant thoughts. So doesn't it make sense that you have to see yourself as receiving it? If your thoughts contain noticing you do not have it yet, you will continue to attract not having it yet. You must believe you have it already. You must believe you have received it. You have to emit the feeling frequency of having received it to bring those pictures back as your life. When you do that, the law of attraction will powerfully move all circumstances, people, and events for you to receive. The universe is going to take care of that. Like I said, the universe will take care of it. It will move everything around for you. It might be moving things around for other people too, who are attracting things too. It's all this big shifting, moving and stuff for all the good of all concerned. When you book a vacation, order a brand new car, or buy a house, you know those things are yours. You wouldn't go and book another vacation for the same time or purchase another car or house. If you won a lottery or received a large inheritance, even before you physically had the money, you know it's yours. That is the feeling of believing it's yours. That is the feeling of believing you have it already. Just like getting paid, like you know you get paid on the 20th or whatever, and it's going to be yours. It's going to be in the bank. You just know it, you know? That is the feeling of believing you have received. Claim the things you want by feeling and believing they are yours. When you do that, the law of attraction will powerfully move all circumstances, people, and events for you to receive. How do you get yourself to a point of believing? Start make-believing. Be like a child and make-believe. Act as if you have it already. As you make-believe, you will begin to believe you have received. Another phrase would be like, fake it until you make it, you know? A lot of people do that. You can see in business and everywhere, and you're like, this person doesn't really have the qualifications for that job. They faked it, but they made it because they saw themselves in that position, and they saw themselves doing these things, and then they did it, and they may or may not be successful, but people who have good imaginations and see themselves a certain way usually are successful because they keep seeing themselves as successful. And then if you're sitting there criticizing, all you're doing is bringing the criticism onto you. So you guys out there that like to criticize, you're not doing yourselves any favor by speaking these negative words. It's just like my daughter says, I say, you're pretty. She says, no, you're pretty. It's because whatever you're saying to someone is you're basically saying it to yourself, and you're attracting it onto yourself. So say good things to people, and you'll be surprised how many nice things happen to you. All right, so the genie, this is a genie because we're make-believing, and I'm so good at this. The genie is responding to your predominant thoughts all the time, not just in the moment you ask. That's why after you've asked, you must continue to believe and know. Have faith. Your belief that you have it, that undying faith, is your greatest power. When you believe you're receiving, get ready and watch the magic begin. You can have what you want if you know how to form the mold for it in your own thoughts. There is no dream that may not come true if you but learn to use the creative force working through you. The methods that work for one will work for all. The key to the power lies in using what you have freely, fully, and thus opening wide your channels for more creative force flowing through you. So, these are just different philosophers, and they're all about saying the same thing. How it will happen. Now, the how. You're very curious about the how, and you want to have control. Ooh, the people, A personality types like me, we're action people. We want to make it. We want to make it come true by the things that we do. But that's not how it works. How it will happen. The how the universe will bring it to you is not your concern or job. Allow the universe to do it for you. When you are trying to work out how it will happen, you are emitting a frequency that contains a lack of faith. And you don't believe you have it already. You think you have to do it, and you have to do it, and that you do not believe the universe will do it for you. The how is not part of the creative process, okay? So even if you get all the other steps right, creative, make-believing, get your visuals, and you get this part wrong, you're still going to be sort of in a limbo because you're too worried about the how. I'm sorry for all of the, I'm not making really any money yet, but that's why these pick of cards and the tarot stuff is so popular, because everybody's concerned about the how, you know, everybody's concerned, is this, you know, what's going to happen in the future, you know. And in some ways, you know, doing it, if it brings you pleasure and it gives you a good positive visualization, if it helps with your positive visualization, then that's good. It's a good aid. And that's why I try to be positive, you know, because whatever helps you positively visualize what you want to attract in your life, I want to be the one to help you do that. But if you are reading things that bring you down and disappoint you, or you're comparing one to another, or you're comparing your events of your day to the tarot and it's not matching up, and you get down and you start to lose faith or whatever. Anyway, the losing faith part is what you're just going to attract. And I am such, yeah, I'm guilty of this, so I have to keep the faith, must keep the faith. So step three, you don't know how it will be shown to you. You will attract it that way. You will attract it just by not knowing how. By just going about your business and not, maybe like a surprise, like I told you, haha, here you go. You open the door, surprise! And it feels great, you know? Most of the time, when we don't see the things that we've requested, we get frustrated, we get disappointed, and we begin to become doubtful. The doubt brings about a feeling of disappointment. Take that doubt and shift it. Recognize that feeling and replace it as soon as you can with a feeling of unwavering faith. I know that it's on its way, or that it's here. It's right here now. It's here. Just not seeing it, but I feel it. It's here. Okay, so step three and the final step of the process is to receive. Begin to feel wonderful about it. Feel the way you feel once it arrives. Feel it now. Feel it. And in this process, it's important to feel good, to be happy, because when you're feeling good, you're putting yourself in the frequency of what you want. This is a feeling, universe. If you just intellectually believe something, but you have no corresponding feeling underneath that, you don't necessarily have enough power to manifest what you want in your life. You have to feel it. That's what it says over here. And it's interesting, I had an argument with a friend of mine, what comes first, the thought or the feeling? And it's very, I think it fluctuates, you know, like you can have, something can happen, surprises can happen that you weren't expecting, and you can have a certain reaction to it, which to me is the feeling, and then the thought comes after the feeling. I generally believe that feelings come first and then thoughts come after feelings, but I do admit there are the times where the thought comes first and then you feel. And then if you have, and I think we have the power to change our thoughts, that just because we're feeling bad, we don't have to think, I'm feeling bad. You know, we can put ourselves in a situation where we're feeling better, even if we're physically not feeling. This is very tricky, but yes, if you physically have a situation, you can still mentally, it's like mind over matter. Have you ever tried that? Like, especially people who are in martial arts know, understand this, mind over matter. Or people who know how to do astral projection, where your out-of-body experiences and stuff. Sometimes a body doesn't necessarily have to match the feelings and the thoughts. Anyway, that goes on to a different tangent, but let's go back to receiving. So now, ask once, believe you have received, and all you have to do is receive, is feel good. When you're feeling good, you're on the frequency of receiving. You are on the frequency of all good things coming to you, and you will receive what you have asked for. You wouldn't ask for anything unless it was going to make you feel good and receiving of it, would you? So go get yourself onto the feeling and frequency that you will receive. A fast way to get yourself on that frequency is to say, I am receiving now. I am receiving all the good in my life now. I am receiving. Feel in your desire now and feel it. Feel it as though you have received. A dear friend of mine, Marcy, is one of the greatest manifestors I have seen, and she feels everything. She feels what it would feel like to have what she is asking for. She feels everything into existence. She doesn't get caught up in how, when, where. She just feels it, and then it manifests. So feel good now. Another thing, like actors out there, method actors, there's two different styles, or more than that, but a lot of times what they do will, in order, like say they have to have a scene where they're crying or whatever, and so they'll remember something in the past that made them cry, and then they get into those feelings, they think about the circumstances of the moment, and they get into the feeling, and they use that feeling to cry for the scene that they're crying in. Same thing with being happy, you know. Even if you're not feeling good necessarily in the moment, remember a time where you're feeling good. Like, if shopping makes you feel good, because that makes me feel good, especially if I find something I really like, you know, or dressing up pretty, or looking good on a particular day. Just little simple things that just kind of, ooh, you know, made you feel good. A kiss, you know, a smile from someone. Just think about those the different things that make you feel good. Think of, oh my God, here we go. Faith just a pixie dust. I told you, this is how it goes. Think of a thought, any happy little thought. Think of Christmas, think of snow. Yeah, and then you can fly. And the fairy dust is, you know, is just putting all these rituals into place to help get you to where you need to go. The faith, you know, this is what we're talking about, faith. Faith in something that we can't see. Trust in the universe that's going to bring it to you. And then just let it go and let them surprise you. So, feel good now. So, how long does it take? That's a biggie. You know, another thing people wonder about is how long will it take to manifest the car, the relationship, the money? I don't have any rule book that says it's going to take 30 minutes or 3 days or 30 days. It's more a matter of you being in alignment with the universe itself. Time is an illusion. Einstein told us that. If this is the first time you've heard it, you may find it hard concept to get in your head around because you see everything happening one thing after another. What quantum physicists and Einstein tell us is that everything is happening simultaneously, like I said before. If you can understand that there is no time and accept that concept, then you will see that whatever you want in the future already exists. If everything is happening at one time, then parallel versions of you with what you want already exists. See, yesterday's today's tomorrow. It's as simple as that. You're like, oh, okay. It takes no time for the universe to manifest what you want. Any time delay you experience is due to your delay in getting to the place of believing and knowing and feeling that you already have it. It is you getting yourself on the frequency of what you want. When you're on that frequency, then you want what you want will appear. There is no time for the universe and no size for the universe. It's easy to manifest $1 as it is to manifest $1 million. It is the same process, and the only reason why one may come faster than the other may take longer is because you thought that $1 million was a lot of money and that $1 was not very much. Alright, so I think we covered all the major topics in The Secret on how to manifest what you want. They keep going to details and talk about different things. They'll talk about how to use The Secret for relationships, for health, for money, all of those subjects. And it's really great, you know, like anything you want's right there at your fingertips. And, you know, I gave this to all my relatives when I discovered it because I wanted everybody to understand The Secret. My brother's really, really digging The Secret, and he's doing amazing work, you know, because he's really great with faith and imagination and stuff. And I think I just have a little bit to work on more, but I'm getting there. I'm doing much, much better, way better. I started thinking differently this summer. I had sort of an epiphany, and it helped a lot. Like I then I started giving and just trying to, this whole change of giving out love and being love and being kind to people. And I've always been kind, but I just felt like I had to do more different styles, something else, something creative, something different. Anyway, so I feel like I'm attracting a lot of stuff, good things to me, good vibes. So anyway, I'm excited for the future. I'm excited for everything coming, and I feel blessed in this very moment right now. No matter what happens, I feel blessed constantly every day. I have a very blessed life. So I hope you do too. I hope you feel great in your life. And if you feel like you need some work in some areas, attracting stuff, manifesting, especially twin flame stuff, man, The Secret will really help you with that. I recommend the book and the DVD highly. So enjoy The Secret, and faith, trust, and pixie dust.